there were these ideas that in eukaryotes, which are organisms like us, who have a true nucleus, the DNA is packed into the nucleus, that on occasion, and maybe quite often, that we're getting genes from prokaryotes, from single-celled bacteria-like organisms that that don't have this true nucleus. And there were reports that this was happening at quite a high rate. So we thought we actually really have to look into this. How do genes flow around the planet in the different organisms? And are there barriers, and who's doing what and where? What we found is that among prokaryotes, these are the organisms without the true nucleus, that the genes are flowing around by all kinds of mechanisms. They're swapping genes. They don't seem to have preferred partners to swap genes. And among prokaryotes, horizontal gene transfer is a dominant means of inheriting genes horizontally from a relative. Among eukaryotes, and that is us, we find that there are only three major flows of genes from prokaryotes into eukaryotes. And in general, these corresponded to the origins of organelles like mitochondria and chloroplasts. But after this, eukaryotes tended not to engage quite as much in this horizontal gene transfer. But instead, they seem to be forming lineages. And the dominant means of evolution is by losing genes from these ancestral genes, but perhaps then making their own new genes by other means. So the manuscript I'm talking about today has just been published in the journal Nature. The work was really led from the University of Dusseldorf by Professor Bill Martin. The manuscript has authors, I think, from about eight different countries, eight different nationalities. The work was carried out in Germany, it was carried out in New Zealand, it was carried out in the UK, it was carried out in Ireland. It's a major international effort to try and get this analysis done. And what we did was we searched every single gene against the database of every single gene, and we found out all the evolutionary linkages between these genes. And when you start putting these together and you make these family trees, these phylogenetic trees, you can ask a few questions. And our first question was this. If eukaryotes are getting genes all the time from prokaryotes, then the eukaryotes will not form a nice group, what we call a monophyletic group. Instead, they'll be infiltrated with these bacterial genes, and eukaryotes will be spread all over the place. We didn't find that. For the majority, not all, for the majority of cases, we found the eukaryotes were pretty much a single group on the tree. The second thing to say is that when we do see genes in eukaryotes that clearly have a prokaryotic origin, they correspond to the origins of these major organelles, that is the mitochondrion and the chloroplast. So plants and their descendants and relatives have these chloroplasts, and they are definitely bacterial in origin. And we can see that signal quite easily. We can also see a signal from mitochondria. These, again, are bacterial in origin, and we can see genes coming in from there. And so this has implications for the spread, for instance, of antibiotic resistance genes. They will be spread, and if we create conditions where the spread of genes is evolutionarily advantageous, then those genes will spread even more and more and more. And so from this work, we can see the high level across thousands of genomes, the high level of horizontal gene transfer. And that's sort of, in some ways, bad news for us in a biomedical sense.